This is one that we did on some irrigated work with an alfalfa crop in Cache Valley. And this particular soil is really heavy and can become waterlogged and all this sort of stuff, and ends up getting a pretty good hard pan, and particularly a tillage plant pan down in. And so when we took this the last year, we raised corn in it. We went through and used two different types of tillage equipments in the fall. And one of them was a ripper like you see out here that we were looking at. The other is a paraplow, which is like a ripper, but it has sort of a lifting action on it underneath. The shafts are quite a bit farther apart. And then, of course, we just use a mobile board plow for the other treatment. Okay, and these are the yields. Of course, this was the first year, and this was all planted in the spring. And the least significant difference was 0.4 of a ton. So if we had a 0.4 of a ton difference in any of these yields, it was significant. So both of these were a significant increase in yield over that that was plowed. And these, by the way, we ripped them about 24 inches deep with both of these pieces of equipment. And we didn't have a significant difference here on that particular year, but the next year when we took our four cuttings, we end up with a considerable difference, significant difference between these two, and a significant difference between those two. And this, the Deep Ripper has done the best job for us. It did it again in 1991, and then our overall average shows the same sort of thing, where we significantly increased the alfalfa yield. And we don't have the yield data in for this year. We got one more cutting to put in, but it's been in, this is the fourth year now, and we can still drive down the highway and just look out there, and I can see the lines where we did these strips. We did them about 200 feet wide and replicated it three times, and so this is a pretty significant increase in yield as far as alfalfa. And again, it's because we're able to get the hard pan broken up, the roots are able to penetrate down, and we're also able to get the water in. And these two particular treatments, we surface irrigate that field, and boy, it takes a lot longer to get the water through the furrows in these two than it does in that one. It just kind of runs off and end up with quite a bit of runoff. With these two, you can just about shut the water off by the time you get it to the end of the field. It's really soaked in, and we're showing a significant yield increase. The Deep Rip is just a little bit different apparatus than what we're talking. It's not this that has a parabolic shaft like this. That one was the one, the paraplow type thing, and it doesn't let the water in. It doesn't leave it as rough. We notice some runoff off of that.
The better chance you have, and I've yet
yet to see one of these that we've really ripped deep and thrown up a lot of clods. They will freeze, regardless of how much water we get in the fall before it goes under snow. And the neat thing about it is when runoff time comes in the spring and the snow melts, the water goes into the ground. And as you can see from the data, that's just exactly what's happened. In those that's been ripped, the water's gone into it. And so if you look across that 3-year period and then you look at the average over here, and you basically see the same sort of a thing that's happened here, where the two ripped ones actually harvested the most water through that winter period, followed by the two that were chiseled, and then quite a bit different by the one that had no type of a tillage operation at all. And this column over here is a percentage of the amount of precipitation. These are the precipitation values that we received during that period, and that's the percentage that we actually harvested or that was in the soil when we made the measurement on April 1st. But you got to remember that we've been talking, those are three pretty dry years, and those yields are considerably less. We, during our winter years, we'll be up in the 50s and the 55 bushel category, and so if we're talking about having 30 to 36 inches of snowpack instead of 8, 9, or 10, which we've had in these period of times, then we may see a more significant increase in water harvest during that period from October 1st to April 1st, and I would suspect that we will see that. And I think if we do, then the economics is going to slide quite a bit in favor of the deep ripping, because we are seeing it in our irrigated stuff, where we can put the water on. And we're seeing a fairly significant increase compared to the two. So if we get back into our good snowpack years, I would anticipate seeing a fairly significant increase to doing that.